The topic of this pencast is multiplying decimals. My name is Darren Lacoste. Multiplying decimals is a lot like multiplying whole numbers. You'll see that they are very similar as we work this example. The instructions say to multiply. We've got negative 0.0641 multiplied by 271. Now when I multiply decimals, I like to put the longest number on the top, not necessarily the number of the largest value, just the one that's longest. When you multiply, the two numbers being multiplied are called factors, and the answer is called the product. The thing that makes this interesting using decimals is that you need to count the number of decimal places in each factor and add them together. This is how many decimal places will be in the product. For this problem, remember that a negative times a positive is a negative. Okay, so let's do our multiplication. Putting the longest number on top, we have 0.0641, and that's being multiplied by 271. We'll draw our line and begin. All right, so we've got a 1 here. We'll multiply 1 by each digit in the factor above. 1 times 1 gives us 1. 1 times 4 gives us 4. 1 times 6 gives us 6. There's a pattern here. Almost every time you multiply by 1, you can take a look at the entire number and simply move it down. Notice that up top we had a 641, and now at the bottom we have a 641. This is because anything times 1 is itself. Alright, so we're through with the 1 in 271, and we're ready to move on to the next digit, which is the 7. But the 7 is in the tens place. To indicate this, we need to use a placeholder 0, which we place right here beneath this 1 in the 641. Alright, let's begin. So 7. 7 is multiplied by 1, which gives us 7. 7 times 4 is 28, so we put the 8 down here and carry the 2 to the next digit. 7 times 6 is 42. Add the carried 2, that gives us 44. Alright, we're done with the 7 in 271, we're ready for the 2. So, 2 times 1, oops, I almost forgot, we've got to use 2 placeholder zeros because we've moved on to the next digit. The 2 is in the hundreds place. Okay, 2 times 1 gives us 2. 2 times 4 gives us 8. 2 times 6 gives us 12. Alright, so I have all of my partial products, and I can draw the line now where I'm going to add them all together. We're going to add right down the row. 1 plus 0 and 0 gives me 1. 4 and 7 is 11, so I'll write this 1 and carry a 1. The 8 and 2 make 10, and then the 6 makes 16 and 1 more makes 17. I'll write that 7 and carry a 1. 4 and 8 are 12. Plus the carried 1 gives me 13. I'll carry a 1 again. 4 and 2 make 6, plus the carried 1 is 7. Nothing to carry this time, so I just bring down the last 1. Now, in my first factor, I notice that I have 1, 2, 3, 4 decimal places. In my second factor, I don't have a decimal, but if you'll recall from my pencast on adding and subtracting decimals, whenever you're dealing with a whole number that does not appear to have a decimal, you just have to remember the place values. The 2 is in the hundreds place, the 7 is in the tens place, and the 1 is in the ones place, which means that there is a decimal here, and it's to the right of the 1. Because of that, we don't have any decimal places. That is to say, there are no digits to the right of that decimal. So we have that there are 0 decimal places in that second factor. We know that we need to add our factors together, add the number of decimal places from each, and that gives us 4 plus 0, which is 4. So our final answer must also have 4 decimal places. So we start at the right, and we move 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces to the left. That gives us our almost final answer of 17.3711. I say almost final answer because remember, this problem was negative 0.0641 times 271. We didn't deal with the negative anywhere in our multiplication problem because we knew that we could multiply the two numbers as if they were positive and then simply tack the negative on at the end. So our final answer is negative 17.3711. Let's try another problem. Is negative 5.5 a solution of the equation negative 6x equals 33? To solve a problem like this, we want to plug in the value for the variable to determine whether or not it's a solution to the equation. So we're going to plug in negative 5.5 everywhere we have an x, and then simplify. If we get a true statement called an identity, then The value we plugged in, negative 5.5, is a solution of the equation. If we don't, if we get something that is a false statement, then we call that a contradiction. Okay, so let's see what happens here. We've got negative 5.5 that we're going to plug in for x. Let's rewrite our equation first. So we have negative 6x equals 33. Now that equation is given to us as true. What we're trying to figure out is negative 5.5 a solution? So let's plug in negative 5.5. This gives us negative 6 multiplied by negative 5.5 equals 33. If you're wondering why it's multiplied, that's because of the convention that we follow in mathematics, that when two things are side by side, that indicates multiplication. The negative 6 and the x are side by side, which means that it's negative 6 times x. Since we're replacing x with negative 5.5, and that is a negative value, that's another good reason why we want to have that in parentheses. Okay, so now we can proceed. We know that a negative times a negative is a positive, so the answer that we're going to get here on the left-hand side will be the same if we write it as a positive 6 times a positive 5.5. So let's write it that way as a simplifying step. Now we are trying to determine if these are equal or not. So I'm actually going to place a question mark above all of the equal signs we've written so far, except for the very first one, which was our equation. Now we're ready to multiply. We want to know what is 5.5 times 6. So I like to put the longer number on top. 5.5 is being multiplied by 6. Here we go. So 6 multiplied by 5 is 30. I put the 0 down here and carry the 3. 6 times 5, well, it's the same as before, so it must still be 30, but in this case we have to add the carried 3, so that's going to give us 33. There are no other digits in our bottom factor, so this is the end of the actual multiplication process, except that we have to figure out where to put the decimal. Our top factor had one decimal place. Our bottom factor had 0 decimal places. That means that since 0 and 1 added gives 1, then our answer is going to have one decimal place. So if we start at the right and move that direction, we find that that's going to be a 33. We would write it 33.0 if it wasn't for the fact that in mathematics, we disregard zeros that are to the right of the last digit in a decimal. So we can just say that this is 33. Okay, so returning now to the equation that we were working on here, we know that 6 times 5.5 is 33. And we want to know, is 33 equal to 33? Well, that's a true statement. 33 does equal 33, so we'll write that this is true, and that is also known as an identity. From this, we can conclude that negative 5.5 is indeed a solution of the equation negative 6x equals 33. So let's write that. Negative 5.5 is a solution of negative 6x equals 33. And that solves our problem. Thank you for listening.